What's going on, everybody? How's your guys' day going? We're back for another episode of the Road to 2K19 series, and we're going to waste no time jumping right into the first game I've ever played back in my home state, my hometown. We're here at Madison Square Garden, and I have a little special waiting for you guys. Since this isn't like any other game, I have a little slideshow ready for you guys. Hope you guys enjoy this. You wanna hate me, then hate me. What can I do but keep getting money? Funny, I was just like you. I had to hustle hard, never give up until I made it. Now y'all saying that's a clever nothing to play with. Hate on me, I blew, but I'm the same OG. People warn me, when you on top, there's envy. Took my people out the hood, but you doubt on us. Saying we left the hood, but can't be my guest. I suggest money is power. I got millions of dollars on salary. Do it now.
You can hate me now.
Come on, people.
But I won't stop now.
But I won't stop now.
Well, there you have it. My first game back in front of my old friends, family, and pretty much the whole state of New York, and having one of my best games of my career in a game like that, that's going to go a long way. And before we jump into this next game against the Miami Heat, and you guys already know who, let's take a look back at these last couple games. And you guys might notice something looking at these box scores. We went 2-1 overall, which is good. But at the same time, I'm starting to fall back into the rotation once again. It seems like every time I make a couple steps forward, I got to take a couple steps back so far in my career. Only 11 minutes here, 9 minutes here, even though I'm putting up good stats in the very limited amount of court I'm seeing. 9 minutes here, 9 minutes there. I'm barely even breaching double-digit minutes. So, unfortunately, it's been tough sledding trying to carve my way a spot in this rotation, but I just got to keep at it. And I'm not going to talk over the Miami PA announcer. Here we go. You guys might recognize a face or two in the starting lineup. Here we go. The Miami Heat and our good buddy Faran, they're on the fringe of a playoff spot, so we already know that they're going to be hungry, trying to come out and get a win in front of their home fans. So it's going to be a tough sledding here in Vice City. Speaking of that, they're also rocking their Vice City uniforms. Very, very pretty selection of jerseys tonight. Running this inbounds play for me, Jahlil Okafor, good screen on Faran, allows me a step, and I take that strong to the tin up with one hand, finishing it with my left hand. Big credit to Jahlil Okafor, my roommate, setting me a good screen. And I know Faran's tendencies on defense. He likes to go for steals, so I'll have to keep an eye out that and go backdoor frequently. But Faran immediately gets those 2 points right back as Hassan Whiteside finishes with the flush. But as you can see, I'm bringing the ball back up the court quickly. High screen roll. This time is Anthony Davis setting me a pick. And that one felt good right as I released it. Perfect jump shot from the elbow. So I got 4 quick points already coming off the bench cold in this game. And now here is Hassan Whiteside going back door to Bam Adebayo. And one of the many welcome to the NBA moments I've had. That's the list right there. Bam Adebayo putting me on a poster. We hold a small lead here. As here is Dwayne Wade. I try to help on him for a second, but look at the court vision displayed by Wade. Faran Nadim knocking down that three-pointer. I don't even think that three hit any rim while it went in a perfect swish. So you guys know I want to get back at him. Can't let that three go unanswered, right? So a high pick roll between Anthony Davis and I. Inside, beautiful post move on Adebayo. And we maintain the lead right now. We're up by three. So I got a couple baskets. I got an assist, but I forced that one over to Jrue Holiday. And Faran Nadim now gets me back as we're exchanging blows, punches going back and forth like a couple fighters, me and Faran. This is how it's been ever since we were young. But look at this cheese. It gets stuck on Dwayne Wade, but I still recover in time. I swat that out of there. Unbelievable. You guys know I'm far from a shot blocker, but I get Ronnie 2K'd a little bit right here. I got stuck on Dwayne Wade, so I had to give some cheese back to the Miami Heat and Faran. But unfortunately for me, ball doesn't lie, I guess. Faran steals it. You guys know he's such a dangerous player in terms of the defensive end of the floor. And I get dunked on by Bam Adebayo. And Anthony Davis falls suit. He gets dunked on by Bam Adebayo. More screen and roll offense between me and Anthony Davis, taking it strong to the cup. Two quick fouls for Faran. He's going to have to play a little bit safer on defense if he wants to stay in the game. As he's got a quick 10 points, though, so I have to try to kill his momentum a little bit if we're going to continue to compete with the Heat. Now I'm at the free throw line. As you guys know, I've been struggling a little bit to begin my career, which is really unprecedented and unexpected because I shot such a high percentage in high school and at college. As you can see, a standing ovation for Faran as he checks out of the game after a very impressive first quarter. I knocked down 2 of 2, and you guys might find out that I shoot a lot better from the free throw line in this episode. I've been doing a lot of driving from up top. This time I drive from the baseline. Anthony Davis open for 3 in the corner, and we grab the lead back from the Miami Heat. And I would remain on the court at the beginning of the second quarter. High screw roll, and I fake like I was going to use it. Double team comes, Bam Adebayo shading towards me, so that's just an easy dump off to Julius Randle, who's played very well this season, an underrated player indeed. And you can see Elfrid Payton as I'm going back on defense giving me a little look like, that pass was alright. Yeah, one of my main detractors, Elfrid Payton, still being a critic. And unfortunately, I allow an and one. Josh Richardson puts in the hoop plus the harm, so that means Alvin Gentry, our head coach, takes me out. But we did lose the lead with Elfrid Payton on the floor, so he wants me to come back in and provide a spark. And on this play, it took me a while to notice Anthony Davis getting double-teamed. I keep trying to run the play, so instead I just move to the rim, and that's about as easy as it gets, right? Yeah, it took me a while to realize I had an open lane there, so. But when I did, I took advantage of it. A surprise there wasn't any foul there for Faran on that layup. Moving it up the court, here comes Stanley Johnson with the and one. And that was a tough fall, so I wanted to be sure I was the first guy to go over there and greet him. He see me fighting through some Miami Heat players, helping him up and pumping him up, showing coach that I'm a good teammate and showing Elfrid Payton how to be a good teammate. I get Goran Dragic stumbling a little bit there. The double team comes, so I just hand it off to Anthony Davis and he scoops and scores right there underneath the tin. Is any of you out there that's kind of like my player in his situation, trying to fight for minutes in a rotation? One, be a good teammate. Two, hustle. Hustle, hustle, like my player's been doing early on this season. I dolphin dive for that steal, and I pull up, but I could not get that jump shot to fall. That would have been a really nice-looking possession right there. But yeah, honestly, that's two great ways to earn more minutes. Be a good teammate and fight for those 50-50 balls. Faran, you saw last possession with a really nice Dirk-looking fadeaway off of one leg, and now in this possession, he drives to the basket, and he's looking to get 2 from the free throw line, and he makes 2 of 2. Now it's Faran at the top of the key. He gets it stolen from Jrue Holiday. I would not be done hustling on the last possession. Look at me diving, sliding across the floor, getting a little bit of burn on my elbows. That one didn't feel so good, sliding across the wood floor like that. If you guys play basketball, you know how that feels. It's not good, but you know it does feel good? Being greeted with high fives and slaps on the back from my bench. Yet another possession, I see Faran getting a little bit too aggressive, and I take advantage of it. I'm now into double-digit points here in the first half. And going into the break, we would be still down by 5, however, so I'm trying to be like the Energizer Bunny a little bit, trying to provide a little bit of a spark. And what's one way to do that? Go backdoor on Faran and punch it down with 2 hands. I know Faran's on fire and leading these Miami Heat right now, but we have a better record than the Heat, and we need to start playing like it. So hopefully, this gives us a little added motivation right here. I get double teamed on the baseline, so instead I just kick it into Check Diallo, who gets fouled. Good play, right? Well, unfortunately, It seems that Coach Alvin Gentry has seen enough. I get subbed out for, of course, Elfrid Payton, would not come back in, and it didn't seem like that dunk gave us the kick that we needed. As Faran, you see he's smiling, he loves it down here in Miami. He led these Heat to a big win here, surpassing Anthony Davis's 34-13, getting the job done. As you can see, me and Elfrid Payton had very similar stats. He had more rebounds, I had more assists, I had more steals, more blocks, and I shot better. Very similar stat lines. Who would you take? Faran, 24 points, 8 assists, 2 blocks, and 1 steal. Man, he is one of the NBA's brightest young stars, only 23 years old, and he's got a lot to prove still. The only thing he has to do is lead these Miami Heat to a playoff appearance. And speaking of the playoffs, speaking of the standings, we'll take a look at that right now. Portland, third in the West. And as you can see, your Pelicans at a respectable 14-11, 103 points per game as a team, marking as one of the best offenses in the NBA. And the Mavericks are right behind us with DeSean Christian. And as you can see, probably the surprise of the NBA, the Denver Nuggets 5-19 early on this season. Now we'll look at the East as the 76ers lead the way. The Cavaliers playing well without LeBron James. We'll continue to scroll down here, and finally we see the Miami Heat just one game out of a playoff spot right now. So Mr. Faran Deem not getting a lot of help down there in Miami, but he's still trying to make the most of it, still trying to stay loyal. Moving on, we face another familiar face not too long after playing the Miami Heat down there, as we welcome the Mavericks to the Smoothie King Center and DeSean Christian, the first time I'm matching up with him in my NBA career. Seeing a lot of familiar faces in these last couple games, aren't we? Just another day in the office as Julius Randle inbounds the ball to me, and we'll get started. We'll open this game on defense. Devin Harris a little out of control, so I help poke it loose as you see three Pelicans really forcing him into that mistake as I take it all the way. Good pass from my teammate, and we hold a early lead, but that lead is cut down to one. Dirk trying to take the lead for the Mavericks, not successful, however. Now, it looks like we don't have numbers, but Stanley Johnson finds a way to get in here, drawing the defense into the paint, so that means I'll be wide open for my patented mid-range shot. I've gotten a lot of baskets there early on in my NBA career. Luka Doncic, no good from three. We need to try to extend the lead a little bit, as we're just in the second quarter, and we're keeping the Mavericks in the game with some mistakes. Let's pull up three from Stanley Johnson, giving me the dime. Now, we'll check in with DeSean Christian. You guys will see in the box score later, he was probably the best player on the court in this game, but a nice rejection from Anthony Davis on this possession. We work the ball up the floor and down the lane. Big Julius Randle putting that one through the rim. Even though we're all now in different parts of the U.S. and stuff, I still keep in touch with these guys, and as you can see, DeSean, nice pass inside. He told me in the offseason while he was keeping in touch with me that he wanted to improve his playmaking, and he had plenty of nice dimes to show for it in this game. As down the lane, a pick and roll. I did that a lot today. Whoever Dirk was guarding, whichever big guy, I would call a pick and roll, and Dirk would either have to switch on me, which would provide an easy matchup for me to take it to the rim, or they would stay on Anthony Davis, Jahlil Okafor, and that'd be an easy matchup in the post for him. Now here on this possession, we're going to play for Etuan Moore and Anthony Davis, but it doesn't work out so well. Once again, another possession where Anthony Davis gets double-teamed, and I just rolled the rim. That's about as easy as it gets. Now in this possession, we try a high pick roll. Once again, you see Dirk's on defense, so it's easy pickings for me to get into the lane. Help defense comes, and Julius Randle is a dangerous mid-range shooter. That's easy money for him. Luka Doncic's half-court shot would not be successful, fortunately for us. And so we hold a comfortable lead going into the second half. And a nice look at my new home here in New Orleans as we hold an 8-point lead. Now I got Dirk on me from a pick and roll where they switched it. Still an 8-point game. I'll make that a 10-point game as I take it right at Dirk. The 7-footer just is not very fleet of foot. Not like he once was. And now I made him pay. Now a high pick roll with Jahlil Okafor as well. You see, we're really not discriminating whoever's on offense and whoever Dirk is covering, that's who's going to score. Jahlil Okafor puts that one in. And as you can see, we're competing here in the NBA in the early goings. 10th in the power rankings for 2K. up the floor, another stop on defense. As a nice look inside to Stanley Johnson. Me and him have actually been connecting more than you'd think early on here in the season. I know on this Pelicans roster, Stanley Johnson isn't exactly a star, not a player that would come to your mind immediately, but that was a good pickup for him, getting him from the Pistons. And of course, Dirk is still on the floor, which means we're still going to attack him. A double move, and that one will lead to a foul. Luka Doncic too early, coming over trying to contest that layup. And I would go perfect from the line once again on this possession. I got 10 points, 7 assists, and a rebound, a couple steals. And now on this possession, I'm covering DeSean, and I'm trying to face guard him, not trying to allow him to get the ball because he's been so good this game. But he does what I did to Faran. Now I see how it feels getting cut back door on as he finishes easy on that break. Close game here in New Orleans as we're trying to hold off Dallas. And here is a demonstration of Jahlil Okafor's best skill right here. Jahlil Okafor is very good at putting the ball on the floor, letting us clear out, and not only scoring baskets, but as you can see here, drawing fouls and using that big body of his to initiate contact. But unfortunately for me, I'd have to check out after this. I would not be seeing the floor anymore in this game, despite how well I played. But we would hold on in a 13-point win. DeSean looking a little disappointed there. But if you'll see his stat line soon, you know, you'll see why he shouldn't be disappointed in himself and how he played. Now, the one downside to all this is that Anthony Davis did suffer an injury. It was minor, so he'll be able to play through it. But we're not going to be seeing the same AD for a couple weeks. In this game, 10 points, 7 assists. Debatably played better than Elfrid Payton. He had 13 and 3 assists, so I'm right there with him, competing for that starting point guard role already. DeSean played 27 minutes, 26 points, only missed 2 shots from the field, 6 rebounds, 6 assists. A very impressive game from DeSean. And as you can see though, good news for me. I'm starting to work my way up in the rotation a little bit. I'm up to the 8th man now, it's just the 10th man. So it's probably a guarantee that I'll be seeing more minutes on the floor right now. Elfrid Payton gets a couple of his minutes docked. I'll definitely be monitoring Elfrid Payton's minutes, and we'll talk more about Elfrid Payton later. Now, moving on a couple weeks, Anthony Davis gets healthy. I'm starting to thrive in that new role, playing as the 8th man. And we're winning some, we're losing some. Now we're 18 and 14 on the season. And as you can see, after the Dallas game, I started to thrive in this new role, in this more explored role. 16 points here, 23 points here, getting close to 10 assists in a couple games, and I put up 15 and 9 against OKC, 22 and 5 against the Miami Heat with 3 steals, 16 points against Milwaukee. So I'm really starting to hit my stride here. The team's starting to see it, but of course, Christmas passed. We are in December 26th. And I get hit with this message. Sean Fitzpatrick set for 0 minutes in the rotation? What happened? I played 20 minutes in this game, the heartbreaking loss to Sacramento. I was playing in the clutch, but unfortunately I suffered a twisted right knee coming down awkward from a layup. So the same knee that you guys already know, I had a skateboarding accident when I was younger, so that's a little bit more vulnerable to injury. But I would only miss one game. I missed the rest of the Sacramento game, but I did come back and play well in that Brooklyn game and that Cleveland game. I shot 7 of 7 from the field overall. And now you see on the schedule, we got a road trip. We faced the Clippers last game, lost to them. And honestly, it would have been really big to win that game, because now we got to play the 37-7 Warriors here in Oracle Arena. Yeah, we're only 24-20, which is, you know, it's a respectable record, but, you know, it's a far cry from 30 games over 500. So we'll have to see how I can do against the best team in the NBA. And immediately, Tim Frazier, I haven't said his name much all season, but the Penn State native knocks down a 3 there. And, you know, that goes back into Elfrid Payton a little bit and what I have to say about him. Tim Frazier seeing some minutes? Well, you know something's up. And so we'll talk about more of that later. Steph Curry open from 3, no good. As you can see, passing the ball to him is Enes Kanter. Kanter was released by the Knicks, and in my career, you can see he's been not picked up by the Blazers, but picked up by the Warriors. But since we're playing Enes Kanter, you guys already know he's a liability on defense. So that means I lobbed Anthony Davis. All in all, Enes Kanter on the Warriors means that it should be a field day down there in the post for AD, as even though he's hurt, hits a turnaround J there. And I'm just want to get him going early. So we're definitely going to need Anthony Davis to ball out if we're going to compete with the Warriors now. And you see, early on in this ball game, they're putting Iggy on me. He was a pest all game, but I stepped back, and I actually hit a three. Once again, you guys know that I'm not the greatest three-point shooter, and I've had trouble finding my range here early on in my career, but I hit one there. Then I record a steal on the next possession up the floor to Tim Frazier, and just like that, I got 3 points, four assists, and only about 5 minutes of action here in the first quarter. Steph Curry trying a floater, no good. Pushing the ball up to me, I see Etuan Moore, who's been very consistent shooting the rock for me, and he's been quietly one of the most efficient shooters for me, and in terms of getting assists, I love playing with him. Two picks for Jrue Holiday, doesn't work. Now they try a high pick roll for me and Julius Randle rolling to the rim. He'll pop from the mid-range, and I wanted him to roll to the rim, but hey, if he wants to stop and pop that mid-range, I'll definitely take that. Now I strip Curry. We're running the floor, going all the way to Stanley Johnson, who floats that layup in. A lot of my assists here in the early going of the season have been going to Stanley Johnson. And as you can see, starting the second half, we are competing with these Warriors. I get subbed in, and we're actually up by 7. We've been doing a good job as a team on Curry as well. That's the main reason why we are controlling this game. I get the ball up top, get Curry there on the secondary move, and I take it to the basket. I had him. I had a step on Curry the first time I drove, but I took it back, made him stumble a little bit, had the momentum shifting, and then I took it strong that second time, and I knocked down both of these. 5 points, 7 assists right now to my name. I get trapped on the baseline, out to Anthony Davis, who's still playing hurt this game. Now I get double teamed, surprisingly, so I give it off to Randle. He's not known for his 3-point shooting, but he knocks down one right there. If I continue to facilitate like this and control the offense like I have been, like a well-oiled machine, I might find myself with some starters minutes soon, as I knock down another jump shot as I take Curry off the dribble. It's amazing how quickly things change here at the NBA level. Just a couple weeks ago, I was having trouble adjusting, and now, look at me getting the steal off of Jerebko. I had trouble fitting into the NBA life the first couple games, but now I'm starting to finally hit my stride as I hit my roommate Jahlil Okafor and set him up for some free throws. Now at the end of the quarter, Curry once again trying to guard me up high. I get a step on him, change directions once again, go down the lane, pump fake, floater, good. And then I'm going toe to toe with one of the best point guards in the entire league right now, and I'm actually giving him a run for his money right now. I'm acting like I belong finally here at the NBA level. I didn't play at all in the fourth quarter, but we still managed to get a big win here on the road. That's really my only complaint right now. I really wish I got some minutes in the clutch time, but hey, a win's a win. Look at that, a big 16 points from Stanley Johnson. Anthony Davis having a field day down in the post, 30 points for him. 9 points, 8 assists off 18 minutes of work, 2 steals as well. Didn't shoot well, but in every other facet of the game, I played phenomenal. And I held Curry to not that many opportunities. So, quick look at the standings. Now we are 6 in the West, 25-20. We're competing right now. We're going to scroll down a couple more spots. The Mavericks starting to lose some more games now, as they're really hurting without Kristaps. So now they're falling into mediocrity. And as you can see in the West as well, you see the Heat still fighting for that playoff spot, about 3.5 games out of the 8th seed right now. So Faran's doing what he can, the Heat, both points per game and assists per game and steals per game. So now we're looking at Elfrid Payton. As you can see, 0 for 6, 3 of 11, 2 of 7 shooting, and a little underwhelming facilitating stats as well, 2 for 7 again. As it seems that the Pelicans are starting to lose faith a little bit in Elfrid Payton, as all of his stats across the board are starting to decrease. Averaging less than a steal per game, he's not playing good defense, his assist numbers are down below what you'd like, only about 10 points per game, he was averaging about 14 but when the season started, and looking at my percentages, all my percentages are going up, I'm close to 50% shooting, 35% from the 3-point line even though I don't shoot them very much, and my field goal percentage is back to normal. And in this upcoming game, the Pelicans and Alfred Gentry, the coach, brought me into his office and said, "Fitz, I'm going to change it up a little bit since we're starting to lose some more games now. Before this last one against Golden State, we lost our last 3. so he wants to try me out starting at point guard. And of course, it's so funny how in this next game we're going to be facing off against the Trailblazers. So my first starting gig at the NBA level, it's going to be against my good buddy Donovan and the Trailblazers. And let's take a look at the rest of the teams while we're here. Faran, of course, fighting to stay alive. And let's take a look at DeSean, fourth on the team in scoring, as he is having a successful rookie year in Dallas. Next time you check in with me, I'll be having my first NBA start, going up against Damian Lillard, Donovan Gray, and the Portland Trailblazers.